So now we learn countable noun and uncountable noun. Countable nouns are the names of things that can be counted. Now the countable nouns are the names of things that can be counted. So the noun which can be counted we call countable noun. For example, the three brothers had many expensive toys. How many brothers? Three brothers. So this brother, this word I have underlined, this is countable noun. Had many expensive toys. How the toys was? Expensive. So toys is also what? Countable noun. We count toy also. One toy, two toys, three toys, like that. There were a few buildings in the two small villages. Now where it were few buildings? In the two small villages. So villages, this is written in plural form. So villages is what? Countable noun. Next is the watches that were kept on the round table were stolen. Now where it was kept? On the table it was kept. So this table is what? Countable noun. Now let's see uncountable noun. Uncountable nouns. The watches that were kept on the round table were stolen. So watches can be counted and table also can be counted. So this is countable noun. Now let's see what is uncountable noun. Uncountable nouns are the names of things that cannot be counted. So there are some nouns which cannot be counted. It is called what? Uncountable noun. See this uncountable noun and countable noun we have learned in 5th standard also. For example, why did you spill the milk, you naughty boy? Now milk, this is what? Uncountable noun. This we measure in liters, this, but it cannot be counted. Have you ever seen writing milks? After writing s to this, we never write like that in plural form. This word is always written in singular form. So milk is what? Uncountable noun. The grass was green on the other side of the fence. Now what was green? The grass. So grass, do we count grass? One grass, two grass? Not like that. So this grass is what? Uncountable noun, which cannot be counted. We can see many grass grown on the ground, and especially in rainy season and winter season. Next is, we had a lot of fun because the sky was blue and not cloudy. Now we had a lot of fun. Fun is also written in singular form only. So fun is uncountable noun because the sky also we cannot count it. It is very big. The sky is very big. So it is describing here the sky was blue and not cloudy. So fun and sky both are what? Uncountable noun. You have to write all these definition along with the example in your English grammar notebook. Next is collective noun. Collective noun. A collective noun is the name given to a group or collection of people, animal or things taken together as a whole. Now, collective noun, this also we have learned in 5th standard. So a group or collection of what? People, animal, things taken together as a whole. Some examples are given here. The gaggle of geese cackle noisily. So, this gaggle is what? A collective noun. For what it is used? It is used for a group of what? This gaggle of geese. Now the second example is, the bride opened the album to look at her photograph. Now the bride opened the album. So this album is what? There are many albums. In album, there are collection of photos. So this word album is what? A collective noun. Next is, the anxious girl looked at the list of names carefully. Now where she has looked, the anxious girl look at the list of names carefully. So list, this is what? A list is what? A collective noun. Now here are some collective nouns. This write down in your English grammar notebook. A class of students, a herd of cattle, a bunch of grapes, a bunch of key, a library of book, a heap of stone, team of player, a pack of card, a crowd of people, a team of player, a flight of bird, a pile of books, a swarm of bees, a flock of sheep, a pride of lions, a litter of puppies, an army of soldiers, a band of robbers, a bouquet of flowers, a bouquet of flowers, a bundle of sticks, a pack of wolves, a shoal of fish, a cluster / galaxy of stars, a gaggle of geese, a panel of judge, a crew of sailor, an album of photograph, a set of tools, a fleet of ships, a brood of chicken, a stack of hay.
Now pick out the proper and common noun from the following sentence. So first one is, I am calling from New Vision English High School. So New Vision English High School is what? Proper noun. So that you have to underline it. First one I have already told. Like that. In rest of the sentence, pick out which word is common noun and proper noun. How was the first day of school? Mrs. Sen asked Rima. When the traveler reached the forest, they were tired and hungry. Socrates was one of the wisest men of the ancient world. Across the Atlantic Ocean, Edison had produced the first light bulb. Faraday attended a lecture given in Humphrey Davy at the Royal Institution in London. So these six sentences are given. Make column like this, proper noun and common noun. And the words which are coming under proper noun, you have to write in the proper noun column. And words which are common noun, that you have to write in the common noun column. Next question is, pick out the abstract and concrete noun from the following sentence and rewrite them correctly in the column given below. So here also abstract noun and concrete noun column you have to make. The lion wanted their opinion. There was absolute silence when Malati sang. A great peace and happiness seemed to fill the room. Kesar did not show any inclination to join the other crows. Devi needed an assistant with an excellent memory. May I now read the books in your store and quench my thirst for knowledge?
So like this, these six sentences are given. From this, make out which words are abstract noun and common noun and write accordingly in that column. Now here is exercise. Underline the countable and circle the uncountable noun in the following sentence. So countable noun you have to underline, and whichever are uncountable noun that you have to circle. The animal got up a little speed and kept its distance. I'll warm some milk for the baby. Come in and have some hot coffee to keep out the cold. His old clothes steamed gently in the heat of the stove. She made the best tea and had the best cookies. High up in the cooler air, the vulture flew. Our king, the lion, has killed your master, said the fox. Now the next question is, fill in the blanks with the correct words, correct collective nouns from those given below. Now these words are given in bracket: album, band, bunch, galaxy, class, crew, fleet, gaggle, library, brood. So in this, you have to read this carefully and write this word. First one is a dash of student. So what will come here? A class of student. So the first one I have told you. So the rest of this sentence words, collective noun, you have to fill in. A dash of books, a dash of robber, a dash of sailor, a dash of geese, and dash of photograph, a dash of grapes, a dash of stars, a dash of ship, a dash of chickens. So this is your homework. You have to write the whole definition along with the examples in your English grammar notebook, and the homework which I have given you, this you have to do on your own and give for submission on my WhatsApp number. Thank you so much. Have a good day.